the last class, we learned that the concept of supervised learning, where we have seen there is a data, that data composed with both input as well as output. This data will be given to a neural network architecture. This is neural network architecture, and this neural network architecture will give rise to a output. Now this obtained output will cross check this obtained output we will cross check with the actual output, and this whatever the error that is there, that error is passed through the neural network architecture, where it will update the weights of the system. So to be precise, let us take an example. Okay, let us take an example of training of a single layer neural network. Training of a single layer neural network. So now here we wanted to train the single layer neural network. So here first of all, you have to know the neural network stores the information in the form of weights. In order to train the neural network with the new information, these weights should be changed accordingly. So the systematic approach modifying the weights according to the given information is called a learning rule. So once again, the systematic approach to modifying the weights according to the given information is called the learning rule. This is again a new word, you should remember this. Okay, so this learning rule is a vital component in the neural network research. Reason being, based on this learning only we'll adjust the weight. Based on the adjust of the weights only, the output is depend upon. Therefore, the learning rule is most important thing in the neural network research domain. So now for us, let us consider a single neural network. You know, we'll simply try to train a single layer neural network. So assume that this single layer neural network composed with 4 inputs: input 1, input 2, input 3, and input 4. These 4 inputs are giving to, say for example, 3 outputs. So let us take any specific term. Okay, so let us take an observation here. Let us take the middle one as an example. The output that is obtained here is yi. Okay, so the information that may go from here to here, the information may go from here to here, the information may go from here to here, the information may also go from here to here. Okay, so for example, this information I call wij. Okay, so here there are the 3 outputs are there. So similarly, the information may also go here. So I'm not doing all these things here, just for your understanding I'm making 2. So similarly the information also will be here like this. Okay, so now in this figure, the error is defined as error of ith iteration is approximately equal to the actual output. So generally this is called the output, that is known output, di minus yi, that is obtained output. This is yi. So ei minus di is the ei, that is error. Based on this error only, the weights, that is ij, is the weights ij are getting updated. So for our further clarity understanding, what we do, we'll take 3 inputs and 1 output. Okay, So there is an algorithm how to update the weight also. That algorithm says the weight wij can be updated based upon the previous weight plus a factor of learning rule and its error, and the output from the node input j. So that is called xj, the output from the node input j, where j belongs to 1, 2, 3 and so on. Okay, and this learning rate alpha may be in lies between 0 to 1. Okay, so now here, you know, the defining alpha is also very very critical. Very high alpha leads to faster response and the solution may also get diverge. Very low alpha also leads to slower response and the solution may get, it takes very longer time. So let us take a concrete example, okay, by considering a single layer neural network which consists of a 3 input nodes, 1 output node, and then we'll try to train the algorithm and you'll observe how things are moving realistically. So this is one input, this is another input, this is another input. Let us assume there are 3 inputs, these 3 inputs, and there is only one output. That one output is y1. So the input here, so this input is given to here, this input is given to here, this input is given to here. Okay, so I am assuming the input as x1, x2, x3, 3 inputs I am giving, and for these 3 inputs, each input has a weight. What is the weight? So this one I am calling as a 1, say for example, so w1 1, so this one and this one, okay, w1 2, so this 2 is coming here, okay, w1 3, so this 3 is coming here, like this it is coming. So now the error of the first one can be written as e1 is equal to d1 minus y1. So based on this only we will update the error. So like, let us take, you know, little more concretely, the first weight that can be updated as w11 is equal to whatever the initial weight that we have given plus alpha into e1 into x1. So here whatever the xj is, here this is the one. W12 can be updated as w12 plus alpha e1 and x2. w13 updated as w13 plus alpha e1 x3. So that is how you will try to update the value here clearly. Okay, so this is how you will try to see to update the value. So as a summary point of view, so that will be very clear for us. First of all, the algorithm, you have to understand this algorithm to make it as a summary. Okay, the algorithm is like this. The step one is first initiate the weights. Whatever the weights are there, initiate the weights with adequate values. Now, and the second point you have to take is, take the input from the training data. So take the input from the training data and enter into the neural network. First we are taking the input from the training data and enter it into the neural network. Once you enter into the looker, calculate the output. Okay, and then after calculating the output, calculate the error. After calculating the error, this is the point number two. After calculating the error and calculate the weight updates. So that weight updates wij, so I am writing ij, wij is equal to alpha ei and xj. Okay, here i1 means here, j1 means 1, 2 means 2, 3 means 3, like this. So now once you get this, update these weights. So now once these weights are updated, these four steps perform for all training data. That means the training data 1 you perform, training data 2 you perform, training data 3 you perform, and repeat these steps 1 2 3 4 5 steps till you reach a acceptable reach a solution which is acceptable tolerance value. So this one, this training is almost identical to the process of the supervised learning. The only difference in the difference in this is the addition of step 6, whereas in the step 6 it just states that the whole training process, the whole model, whole training process repeated. Once the step 5 has been completed, the model has been trained with every data point. Okay, so here you may be having a question like, okay fine, we have trained the data and we got the output and we adjusted the weight. Now so here how many iterations that we do, you know, generally we can do any number of iterations depending upon the requirement of solution. That we are calling as a epoch. So this is a new word again, epoch, epoch. Epoch means all the training data goes through step 2 to 5 is called one epoch. All the train data, if there are mentioning 10 epochs, means the training data gone 10 times with the same data set. So like this, it's same data set in the sense, why this, if you take the same data set and then train it again and again and again, the error that is there in the system may reduce. That is the reason why that is happening here. So I hope you will get, you have got a clarity how a simple training on a single layer neural network was done. In the next class we'll see about a generalized delta rule.